Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. One of the names that was given to the month of Ramadan is the month of the Quran, the month of reading the Quran, and it's the month that the Quran was revealed. There's much more names that relates the Ramadan to Al-Quran. When any one of us think of Ramadan, two things come to our mind, if not three things right away. Number one is fasting. Number two is the Quran. And number three is Taraweeh, which is a salah, but we are reading Quran. And we all ask, are we going to have a khatma? Are we going to finish it? How many ruk'ah they will pray, and how much of the Quran they will read. So the Quran is very much related and connected to Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala actually taught us this in the Quran, in Surah Al-Baqarah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the verses of fasting. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu kutiba alaykum as-siyam. O you who believe, fasting has been revealed upon you. Then in the next verse, he says, شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ. The month of Ramadan is the month that the Quran was revealed. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala defined Ramadan. And remember, Allah is the one who knows everything, who chose the best. The Quran is his words. And he chose, subhanahu, that Ramadan, that month of the year, that he decided, subhanahu, to reveal the Quran in it. What does that bring to my heart? Alhamdulillah, we all have a lot of awe to Ramadan. We see it every single day. I can't believe I can't fast. It's Ramadan. Alhamdulillah, may Allah keep this, young and old. We need to bring even more the awe to the Quran, way more than what we currently have, for many reasons. Number one is the words of Allah. And how do we define Quran? Kalamullah is the words of Allah that was revealed to our Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam through Sayyidina Jibreel. The angel reached to us through uninterrupted chain. And it is act of worship to read it. And it is written between the two covers of the Mus'haf or the book. So the Quran itself is the words of Allah by itself should change me, should give me a feeling. Add to it that Allah chose the month of Ramadan and defined the month of Ramadan, that alhamdulillah, we all absolutely not only acknowledge, but we honor. He defined the month of Ramadan by الذي أنزل فيه القرآن, not by the month that you need to fast right away. Number one, the month that the Quran was revealed. And when was the Quran revealed for all of us to learn? And also in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said it in two places. في سورة الدخان, the smoke, he said, حاميم, تلك آيات الكتاب المبين, حاميم والكتاب المبين, حاميم, by the clear book, inna anzalnahu fi laylatin mubarakah, we have sent it down in a blessed night. Which is, what is this blessed night? In another surah, inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr, we have sent it down in the night of power. The relationship between Ramadan and Quran is in many levels. Number one, Allah revealed it to us, to the humanity, in the month of Ramadan. When I pick up that Quran, I need to look at the Quran, not only the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not only an act of worship, but it is the words of Allah that he decided, chose to send it down in the month of Ramadan. So in these days, when I pick up the Quran, I have to say something so special in the connection of the Quran with Ramadan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how did the Quran reach us? This is something for all of us to learn. And if we know, to remember and to reiterate this knowledge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Quran is his words. This is the words of Allah. And in the most agreed upon opinion, it was sent all as one book, min al-lawh al-mahfuz, from the preserved tablets. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is something beyond you and me, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent it down, his words, in the lawh al-mahfuz. He put it in the preserved tablet and then send it down fi laylatul qadr, in the night of power, through Sayyidina Jibreel to the lower heavens, samawat al-dunya, the whole book. This is beyond, again, you and me, but I need you to feel it. What an honor this Quran is, and what an honor this month that Allah honored it even more with the book. So the book, the words of Allah, all together came once to the lower heavens. And then from the lower heavens, Allah sent it down in piecemeal, bit by bit, according to the circumstances, according to the incidents. Some was revealed in Mecca, some was revealed in Medina, some was revealed in Jerusalem. One or two verses were revealed in the heavens, fil mi'raj. That's how the Quran was revealed. But all of it was fi shahri Ramadan, in this blessed month. And on a Monday, wallahu alam, based upon a hadith of Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam that an Imam Muslim narrated, and when he was asked, why do you fast on the month of Monday? In one narration, he said, it's the day I was born, it is the day I was bu'ith, the day I was sent as a prophet, or it is the day that the Quran was revealed to me. So look at the place. The place is Gharu Hira, is in the cave of Hira. The time, it's the month of Ramadan. And the day is the night of Al-Qadr. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, taught us. And this question will come to all of us. How much Quran we have? How much Quran we have in our hearts? And how much Quran we read well? We read well, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. All of us these days, we know a lot, whether it's in our field, whether in other fields, we read a lot, alhamdulillah. And the more educated we are, the more people look at us and respect us. Alhamdulillah, that's good. But what about the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How much we know this book that was revealed all at once from the preserved tablet to the lower heavens, and then gradually to Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, the words of Allah. And the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam said this hadith, the parable of the believer that has Quran is like a citrus fruit, taste good and smell good. Think of it this way. When I learn the Quran, when I read the Quran, it is like I smell good and I carry good, like a good ripe citrus fruit. And the believer that does not read the Quran, he is like a date that has no smell but tastes good. Because a believer, the fact, believes in Allah and the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, the inner side of it is beautiful, the internal part is beautiful. But if you want to smell good, as the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam taught us, let us start reading the Quran. And the parable of the hypocrite who reads the Quran so he will smell good is like the basil. Basil, smell good, but it is bitter. And the hypocrite who does not believe, who does not read the Quran and doesn't believe, is like this kind of a plant which does not smell and taste bitter. The book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah have elevated it. Allah have honored it and honored the month of Ramadan by having it, chosen it as the time, the month of the year that He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, chose to send the Quran in it. All of it, one to the lower heavens, and then piece by piece or part by part depends on the circumstances. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the Quran rabi'a qulubina. Ya Allah, Ya Kareem, you are the generous. Make the Quran the spring of our heart, the spring of our heart, and the cause the mean that our worries are removed, and the means that our sorrow and sadness is removed. That's the dua of Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. Allahumma ja'al al-Qur'an al-azim rabi'a qulubina. Ya Allah, make the glorified Qur'an the spring of our heart, wa dhahaba humumina, and it's the agent that remove our worries, wa jala'a ahzanina, and the agent that clear our sadness, ya Rabbi, ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the resolve, the himmah, the strength, the power to focus on his book in this month, to learn more about his book, to recite more of his book, ya Rabbi, ameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.